Hello everyone. Today I would like to present about my physics project in this term 2. So our project focus questions is how can human analyze the transformations based on the physics concepts and law in the day-to-day life activities. Second, our big questions is why do visionary leaders adapt? In this term 2, we have two outcomes. Our first outcome is able to analyze the daily life problem based on the principle of war, energy, and power. Our second outcome is able to develop a forward thinking design based on the understanding of Newton's law of motions. So in the free body diagram, in this picture besides, as you guys can see, the picture beside, there was a person holding a bow. And he tried to pull the arrow that was attached with the bow. Once he pulled the arrow with a tension, it also gave him a friction force because of the rope that was holding back the arrow from the tensions, and it gave the friction force to the opposite directions. The gravitational force is a force that attracts any object with a mass, and in the picture besides, there was a the person also have a gravitational force because he has a mass, and also he has a normal force that was opposite direction from the gravitational force. Next is about the Newton's first law. It says that an object at rest remain at rest, or if it in motions remain in motions at a constant velocity unless act on by a net external force. As seen from the picture beside, the boy at the right side has a greater inertia as he has a greater mass. The seesaw moves because of the unbalanced force. Once the boy at the left has reached the highest point from the seesaw, he will fall back down. Next is about this Newton's second law. The Newton's second law says that when a constant force acts upon a massive body, it causes it to accelerate. In the picture beside, there was a man that was walk on top of a rope. His feet has a constant force that makes him walk. Also, his feet that has a constant force has to act upon his body weight, and it causes to accelerate. The picture beside is one of the great example of the Newton's second law, because the constant force from his feet acts upon his body weight and it creates an acceleration. The Newton's third law says if an object A exerts a force of an object B, then object B must exert of equal magnitude and opposite direction back on the object A. So the picture besides is one of the example of a Newton's third law. As seen from the picture, the arrow that attached to the bow is pulled with a force, and when it releases the arrow gives some reactions when it releases. The potential energy means an object can store energy as the result of its positions. In this case, the person of on the left was being lifted. When it reached the highest point, and it will fall back down. The potential energy follow the formula of mass times gravity times height. In the first given, the first person has a 23 kilogram with a gravity 9.8 meter per second square, and has a height of 0.2 meter. And the second person has a 21 kilogram with a gravity of 9.8 meter per second square, and has a height of 0.4. So with the calculation of mass times gravity times height, for the person number one has a 45.08 joule, and the second person has a 82.32 joule. Next is about the kinetic energy, means form of an energy that an object or a particle has by reasons of its motions. In the picture besides, the person is running, which means the person has a kinetic energy. The kinetic energy has follow formula of Ki E equal 1.2 times mass time velocity square. In the first given, the first person has a 24 kilogram with a velocity of 2 meter per second, and the second person has a 21 kilogram with a velocity of 2 meter per second. So to do the calculations, to find the kinetic energy, we need to times the 1.2 with a mass with a velocity. So the first person has a 48 joule, and the second person with has a kinetic energy of a 42 joule. Next is the conservation of energy. The law conservation of energy states that energy can neither be created nor destroyed, only converted from one form of energy to another. As seen from the picture beside, the person was trying to pull the arrow with attention, as seen when he pulled the arrow. With a rope that hold back the arrow from the tension, it gives the friction force to the opposite directions, and it creating an energy that will help the arrow to travel to its destinations. So in this case, it has a given point with a 0.2 kilogram and a gravity of 10 meter per second square, and has a height of 1.7 meter. So to find the point A first, we need to find the potential energy, kinetic energy, and the mechanic energy. So to find the potential energy, we need to use a formula of mass times gravity times height. the potential energy of point A is a 5.1 joule, and kinetic energy of point A is a 0 joule, because it's times with a half times mass times velocity square. And the point A, to find the mechanic energy of point A, we need to substitute the potential energy of point A with a kinetic energy of point A, and the result of mechanic energy of point A is a 5.1 joule. To find the calculation of potential energy, kinetic energy, and mechanic energy of point B, it has this the same method with the to find the point A. So in the conservation of energy, mechanic energy A is equal to mechanic energy of B. So the result in this case is a 5.1 energy A, it's equal to 5.1 of mechanic energy B. Next, so our big questions is, why do visionary leaders adapt? So when a visionary leaders learn the transformations in day-to-day activity, it will lead them, for the visionary leaders adapt on the changes that exist in the everyday life. So our project focus questions is, how can human analyze the transformations based on the physics concepts and law in the day-to-day life activities? So transformations can be seen in the day-to-day life activities. With a transformations that can be seen in the day-to-day activities are lead humans to adapt and analyze the transformations. One of the example is a Newton's law. With a knowledge that want to adapt, people will be able to more analyze the change that exists in everyday life. Thank you for listening.